his form no more.
So as this is being photographed by the wonderful Peter Simmons, we'll do him a Simmo. S-I-M-M-O. And starting at the beginning. S-I-1-M. A second M. Done the bottom, we now have to go back along the top, which is the hard bit.
Not the same, it is sad, oh,
Thank you. in this old town. No more good stuff going down. The money men have had their way. We're still poor when we get paid. So I'm off to where they have the power, where people work in shining towers, and money just don't come too hard, where the streets are paved with credit cards. Hey, I'm going down to London town. Going down to London town. London town. Going down to London. Going down to London. Well, I'll find myself a millionaire's. Get her in a state of undress. Spend her money fast as I can. I'll make myself a wealthy man. Go off and be a merchant banker. For insider trading deals I'll hanker. Climb on up that slippery pole till I'm the one who's in control. The very top, when I'm the king without a crown, I'm gonna bite the hand that feeds, bring the whole thing tumbling down, bring the whole thing tumbling down, watch it all come crashing down. I'm going down to London town.
Will that be not a trace left behind? mover and shaker in the world of folk music, and one who promoted unknown singers in particular, and songwriters and performers. Unfortunately, it was taken from us suddenly. Well, to me it was sudden. I know there was a 3 month long illness, but it was still a shock when he left, because he was still quite young. So I'll dedicate this one to Terry. I think it will be appropriate. And again, I think several of you will know the chorus. I will not bother introducing it. Please join in. Well, last week I worked and toiled, did my best without respite. Now I've put all that behind me, all my troubles out of sight. I've been waiting since last Sunday just to be with you tonight, just to join my voice with yours and sing a song with all our might. Who needs fame and who needs fortune, and who needs a life of ease? I'm the richest in the country when I'm blessed with friends like these. Sing of joys and sing of sorrows, sing of love and bloody wars, and as we sing we're all transported. Now some might go to distant shores, some sing high and some sing low, and some sing sensitive and sweet. But when we all join in chorus, they can hear us down the street. Who needs fame and who needs fortune, and who needs a life of ease? I'm the richest in the country when I'm blessed with friends like these. Landlord, bring another round now, set him up in twos and threes. Come again when these are empty, till we buckle up the knees. Let our ears be filled with music, just as we are filled with ale. Let this evening never end, and let our voices never fail. Who needs fame and who needs fortune, and who needs a life of ease? I'm the richest in the country when I'm blessed with friends like these. And one day, if we should part and we should meet no more again, Sunday nights, let's raise our glasses to the health of absent friends. And if angels take you with them, and the devil claims my soul, we'll still harmonize together, you above and me below. Who needs fame and who needs fortune, and who needs a life of ease? I'm the richest in the country when I'm blessed with friends like these. Who needs fame and who needs fortune, and who needs a life of ease? I'm the richest in the country when I'm blessed with friends like these. Thank you, Terry.
You can go and have a go at being a blacksmith with two lovely fellas. One's called Simon and one's called Ollie. And I done noticed their anvils and equipment out there. And I said, come on, lads, come on, this is your big moment. Let's have you. Big hand for Simon and Ollie. They're here all weekend. Go and see them. They're just over there most of the weekend. They will give you an example of what they have got no idea of where to play during this song. So whatever happens, it's not their fault. So I go. We'll be right back. blacksmith courted me 9 months and better. He fairly won my heart, wrote me a letter. With his hammer in his hand, he looks so clever. And if I were with my love, I would live forever. Gone across the seas gathering primroses. I'm afraid the shining sun would scorch his beauty. And if I were with my love, I would do my duty. Come to town, strange news is carried. News flies up and down that Simon is married. Well, I wish them both as joy, though they won't hear me. And may love reward them well for the slighting of me. You promised me when you lay beside me. Ollie, you said you'd marry me and not deny me. Well, if I said I'd marry you, 'twas only to try you. Bring your witness, love, and I'll not deny you. Sweat. Amazing, guys. Oh, shit, no, don't get him back. Don't get him.
Along the Rue Hello, and I wonder what would Mungo make if he could Yeah. Thank you. This is a song I saw, I honestly saw a pirate in the bar. So it's for the pirate, and it's for you. We have to dance a bit more. Thank you.
so much.
You staying there, Bet? Are you moving back over? A bit lonely.
I've got that many pedals in front of me, you'd think I'd have like a range of special effects, but it's just three tuned.
Music by Peter Bellamy, and he's one of our sort of great heroes in this band. And we really love the chorus in this as well. If you want to join in, this is your chance. The chorus goes, "The people, oh the people, are good enough for me." And it'd be really great to have your company singing this one. Every pride, little I am blind.
like old Maggie's farm no more. I said I ain't gonna work on Maggie's farm no more. Get up in the morning, fold my hands and pray for rain. It's a head full of ideas that are driving me insane. It's a shame the way she makes me scrub the floor. I ain't gonna work on Maggie's farm no more. He hands you a dime. He asks you with a grin, are you having a good time? And then he finds you every time you slam the door. I ain't gonna work on Maggie's farm no more. Just for kicks. His bedroom window is made out of bricks. The National Guard stand around his door. I ain't gonna work on Maggie's farm no more. Servants about man and God and law. Everybody says she's the brains behind war. She's 68 and she says she's 54. I ain't gonna work on Maggie's farm no more. I ain't gonna work on Maggie's farm no more. Here. We have just reached the call and response section. You know what that means, don't you? It means I call and you I ain't gonna work on Maggie's farm no more. I said I ain't gonna work on Maggie's farm no more. Hold it, fellas. I think there's a mutiny going on. I'm taking out one ear so that I can hear you properly. I ain't gonna work on Maggie's farm no more. Someone isn't singing. In fact, I think it's two people. I have a word for you two. Everyone else is having more fun than you are. I ain't gonna work on Maggie's farm no more. Work on Maggie's farm no more. I ain't gonna work on Maggie's farm no more.
not leave that one in future. I said I ain't gonna work, but I ain't gonna work. Hold it right there. Look, if you're in paid employment and you'd like to keep it that way, don't sing this bit. Because it's a well-known fact that midges are getting worse. It's a well-known fact that you have what you say with your mouth. So if that's you, just keep stum for this bit. I ain't gonna work. I ain't gonna work. I think they're all retired. I said I ain't gonna work. No, 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 no. No, 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 no. Well, no, no. No, no. You're funkier than you look. I ain't gonna, I'm not saying something. I ain't gonna work on Maggie's farm no more. I said I ain't gonna work on Maggie's farm no more. Because she talks to all the servants about man and God and law. Everybody says she's the brains behind Pa. She's 68. She says she is 54. I ain't gonna work on Maggie's farm no more. I ain't gonna work on Maggie's farm no more. I ain't gonna work on Maggie's farm no more.
Crawling on my knees. Just to say that Santa Tradition, that was absolutely beautiful. That was for the Harvey Block Cup. Those who were in earlier heard Wendy talking about Harvey earlier. He was a local cornerstone of the folk scene around this part of North Yorkshire and beyond. To be fair, he's from the northeast originally, so well known up there as well. He died last year. He was president of Bamfest. But he didn't live long enough to see the first one, which is a shame. But Lizzie, his daughter, has been intimately involved this year. She's been helping out, which has been fantastic. So the Harvey Block Club is sponsored by Beedale Acoustic Club, which is run by John and Pam Knight, and who are obviously part of the committee for the contest. Which leads me nicely on to, and it's possibly a little bit self-indulgent, but you know, to put on a festival like this, some of you I know have done things yourself, and you understand the amount of work. you've been doing it for 90 years, Mr. Cleck Heaton Festival Organiser. We're new to it. It's fraught. It's difficult, but it's worth it. In about 2 months' time, the committee will be able to say the word Bamfest to each other again. In the meantime, we're going to take a holiday, not see each other and not speak to each other, just to let the dust settle a bit. So I would like to thank each individual member of the Bamfest committee. So, Mike Dillon. Mick Darling. Susie Darling. Yeah. Wendy Arrowsmith. Yeah. And especially Pam Knighton, who I think, I'm surprised she's got any hair left, really. Absolutely brilliant in terms of keeping us on track. This could be really embarrassing. I haven't forgotten anybody on the committee, have I? Yeah. Oh, I have. No, I've forgotten Carol, but we'll come to Carol in a minute. Oh, I forgot John. Oh, John, I'm sorry, mate. So Bamfest was born. And I give John a big round of applause. How embarrassing. So Bamfest was born. John and I sat in the pub one night and said, I've been running Kirby Fleet and Folk Club. He runs Beedale Acoustic Club. But, it'd be a really good idea to have a local festival. So we went home told our wives, they organised it, and we just have a really good time now. No, it's true. Right, so that's the committee. This festival just would not be possible without Carol, David, Jared and Duncan Clark, who run Bitchy Little Cow. It's their business. No, bigger round of applause. They are fantastic people. Just nothing has been too much trouble. I cannot begin to say how much we owe to them. And Carol in particular, who's also chair of the Bamfest committee and has done a fantastic job, again, along with Pam, of keeping us on track. There might be a little something for Carol. She said, I'm not going on stage. So I'm not on stage, Carol, so please come to the front. See you live. One other person, we think we've worked hard as the committee members, and to be fair, we have, but keeping everybody supplied with carbohydrates and tasty treats has been Sarah, who's been working in the bakery and food in general all weekend. She is putting so many hours, it's just not feasible. So a big round of applause for Sarah as well. So Sarah and Carol, we've got some flowers for them. Is that the whole committee coming up? I think the whole committee should come to the front as well. Mick, Susie, Wendy, I want you to come to the front as well. Mike, if you're around, we can't see you. Yeah, there you are. Thank you, Peter. Yeah, give them a massive round of applause. They've done a fantastic job. It's been a brilliant weekend. Now, come to the front, guys. Come to the front and take a bow. You could get on the stage with people. Yes, of course you can. Briefly. Right. It takes a committee, it takes people, but it also takes beer to power a folk festival. So I would also like... Sorry, a music festival. Sorry, John, it's not a folk festival. I forgot. So I'd like to thank our main sponsors as well, which is Theakston's. And if you haven't tried their wares yet, make sure you do before you leave, unless you're driving.
Dangerous putting me near a mic, Paul.
Sorry, Mike. I'm sorry, Mick.
Dangerous putting me near a mic.
Well, that's all I've got to say.
I have an update for you. We've drunk the bar dry.
Again, that's the second time this weekend.
So we do have bottle beers available.
So, big round of applause. Take a bow, guys.
Listen, if you weren't here, it wouldn't have happened. Give it all yourselves a big hand. Come on. God bless you all. Thank you for coming.
We've worked very hard over these last few weeks, and you start to worry about how it's going to turn out. But I'd just like to say... What? Oh, right, sorry. I'd just like to say how much the festival has been successful because of all of you. Everybody we've met has been friendly and helpful and had a smile on their faces. And that is what makes a good festival. And I really would like to thank all of you who've come, all of the volunteers who've helped enormously to make this festival a happy occasion. And that's what we need. So thank you very much, everybody.
If there's anybody who feels that they haven't been thanked who should have been, I'd just like to thank them as well. Oh, I've got to thank... Oh, Morris Dancer's got to thank them, yes, of course. But anybody else as well, things like, you know, thank you. As my friends and colleagues have said, thank you to all of you for coming.
Fall out, Joe, I'm still friends with you now. Give me a...
Oh, my God, this is sweet. Come on.
Just one other thing. We still have our L plates on and we're still learning, and it's really important that we get your feedback. We know that we still have lots of things to improve, lots and lots of things to improve. We need your feedback, but most of all, can I tell you that next year, if you come, there's going to be showers on this site. We get your feedback, and criticism is what we need. So you don't have to be too gentle, but criticism helps us improve because we want it to be really good and keep moving forward. So thank you very much.
The Bathurst Committee. Right, enough with that self-indulgence. Let's get.